I've been playing Les Pauls since I was 15 years old. Everything about these guitars to me is perfection. The shape, the feel, the sound. When I think about playing music, when I think about writing music or performing live, the first thing I envision in my head is a Les Paul. I'm inspired by the guitar players from, I would say, like 1968 to 1980. Blues rock guys to me really spoke when I was coming up learning how to play. I heard guys like Eric Clapton playing Crossroads, Peter Green in Fleetwood Mac, Paul Kossoff in Free. It was this cool feeling where these guys, you knew who they were by just one note, by one bend, you could tell the guitar player who it was. Guys like Leslie West, their playing really spoke to me because it had a quality to it that was so much deeper than anything I'd ever heard. There was something about it that kind of spoke to me and it got into my soul. These are the things that really took it from being, okay, this is great guitar, to this is changing my life. This is changing who I am as a guitar player. Just got off an airplane from Spain. I've been up for like 10 days, I swear. I'm with my friends at Gibson, checking out the brand new 50's Les Paul Standard Gold Top. The new Les Paul Standard Gold Top has the same vibe and the feel and the articulation with the volume and tone that you get comparable to a 50's model, you know, a true 50's. There's something about those old guitars where you can sit on a note and it really resonates. You're not rushing around trying to get to the next note. You know, you can really hang on it and really soak the tone out of it. And they really knocked it out of the park with these audio taper pots because they actually work. You roll back the volume and it actually cuts just what you need to. The frequencies are really cool on this. It's crazy when you can just roll it back even one, just one from 7 to 6 and hear the difference. It's like you can play the same lick 3 times, mess with your tone knob and get 3 completely different sounds. The P90 can get you any sound that you want out of a guitar. From the bell crystal-like sounds, the very clean articulate sounds, and the aggressive and, you know, dirtiness of a humbucker. I can close my eyes and literally between these 4 knobs, this switch, anything in between, I can get any sound out of my head. For me, when I go on stage, I pick up my guitar, I strap on my Les Paul, it's got weight to it. It's not weight relieved, you know, it's hefty. Feels good. The neck feels great on this, man. You know, it's got the vintage feel. You know, it has character. So when I picked it up right away, a thing I always check out with Les Pauls is how it bends, how it sustains, and how I can hold a note. It's kind of got like a thicker 50s profile, but it still is articulate enough where you can, you know, if you want to do fast runs, it's really smooth all the way up. The first ones, they were gold tops, just like this. We're going back to 1951, 52 when they came out. They were gold tops, and this color, like this gold, it's hard to get that and to get it to look right. And you know, they did it. I think that gold tops are, you know, it's the classic Les Paul. But when you think about a proper, true, original spec Les Paul, it's gonna be a gold top. It's nice to see the classic tuners, the Gibson Deluxe tuners. These have been around obviously forever, and to see them on the models of today, you know, it's just reassuring. Every part of this guitar is reassuring. When you play it, you go, ah, that feels right, you know? They're new parts, but they harken back to what really was on the originals. It's awesome. I feel so honored, first off, to play Les Pauls, to play blues and blues rock music in the modern day. For me, it's really important that when I pick up my Gibson Les Paul, it feels the way I want it to. The guitars they're making now, when you pick up a Gibson Les Paul like this, you know that you're getting something that's obviously quality. You know, it's a cornerstone of American music. It's everything we've been growing up listening to. But you're also getting the ultimate tone machine, man. There isn't anything you can't do on this guitar. And you know, you get to pick it up and sound like you. That's the beauty of it. We'll be right back.